Thank you for joining me for another random map how-to thing. The reason I'm over here instead of where I normally am is because this time of year I get a laser beam into my eyeballs. The other day I shared on the community, a few months ago I was asked to make some B-roll graphics for the Esri user conference for, you know, between stuff at the plenary. We need a neat looking map of San Diego. And so I made a street map version of San Diego that used streets to kind of pop. I don't know, what the heck did I do? It was imagery, but I used the streets layer to make it pop. I embossed it using the streets layer. I embossed imagery using the streets layer. This is nothing new. I've done this with water in the past, and then I forgot about it. And then a little while ago, I shared it on YouTube and Instagram, just a picture, and I said, oh, you know, I made this thing. I just stumbled on it again. Maybe you'd like to look at it. And a lot of people said, hey, how do you make that? I want a how-to. We demand a how-to. Here is that how-to. Couldn't be easier, I'm happy to say. First of all, we'll build our base map, and the primary layer is going to be world imagery. And I'd like to make this imagery more vibrant. So I'll dig into the base map layer. With world imagery selected, I'll go to the effects options and I'm going to activate saturate, and I'll boost the saturation to 125. And next I'll add from Living Atlas bathymetry light. This is a world, ocean, water, river layer. And I'd like to deepen the tone of bathymetry light. So I'm going to activate brightness and contrast and give it a brightness of 60 and a contrast of 300 all the way. And then lastly, for the base map, I'll add a labels layer. Also from Living Atlas, this one's called Human Geography Dark Label. And then I'll just drag it up into the reference area so that the labels show up on top of whatever layers I might add to this map later. In this next bit, I'm going to be adding a street layer. And then underneath that, I'm going to be adding another imagery layer. And I'm going to use the street layer like a cookie cutter. Do you see this? This is a chicken. This is what it's like making maps in a woodshed, people. Anyway, I'm gonna add a very special layer. This one is just from ArcGIS Online. It's a version of the human geography detail, but I've removed all the water using the vector tile style editor. It's called Human Geography Detail Dry, and it's a global vector tile layer of roads, buildings, borders, airports, that kind of thing. Part of the human geography suite of base map resources lovingly tended to by my friend Andy Skinner. Okay, and next I'll add that second copy of world imagery, and I'll search Living Atlas for imagery, and here it is. But oh no, I've covered everything up. That's okay, it's time for some layer management. I'll drag that new world imagery underneath my streets layer, and then I'm gonna group my streets layer, drag the world imagery into that group on the bottom row. And now for the magic, the combination of the ArcGIS Online map viewers, blend modes, and effects make for some just bananas possibilities, and I love it. With that human geo streets layer active, I'm gonna go into the blend mode options, and I'm gonna give it a blend mode of destination atop. It's a cookie cutter. Because I have them grouped, we're only seeing this new world imagery layer where we have streets. But you can't really tell because the base map is imagery too. So I'll select that whole group and I'm gonna give it a drop shadow. And the result is all imagery, but imagery that casts a shadow where there's streets.
What a time to be alive.
Let's make these cookie cutter streets a little bit brighter. So I'll select this grouped street masked version of imagery, and I'm gonna give it an effect. I'll boost its brightness and contrast. I'll set them each to 125, a little bit brighter, a little bit more contrast than normal. And I'll also increase the saturation to 125 because that will make it more delectable. And here's a little before after toggle to get a sense of what we've wrought. At this scale, it's the built environment. But if we zoom out, we transition into boundaries, which is also sort of a built environment, just a different kind of built. Some of the things I like about this style is that the reference layer doesn't obscure the imagery. It just elevates the imagery along those borders in a way that gives it some cool dimensionality. And at closer scales, I just love how the bridge imagery overlaps the vector water polygons, like a little model. Here's a few before after snapshots just for fun. I hope you make your own, but if you're pressed for time, you can just use mine. Look for it on ArcGIS Online. It'll be called Embossed Streets. Even though that's not the best name, because I mean, obviously there's borders and there's roads, but whatever. Embossing for the win. By the way, this chicken's name is Speck. The girls call her Little Man. I don't know why. She's a bantam, which is a miniature chicken. And she lays little miniature eggs that look like this.